Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. You're joining me in the flight deck of the Fenix A320, and in this video we're going to look at the descent. So we're just approaching our descent marker here, the top of descent, indicated by the white down arrow, and we've been cleared by air traffic control down to flight level 260. If we get an early descent before the top of descent, just select that now, we're going to descent mode. The aircraft will descend at a rate of 1,000 feet per minute until it intercepts the optimal path. So the optimal path is indicated by this green ball here, which is coming down now. So we've just crossed that top of descent, and now the descent rate will increase. And in descent mode, cross-idle descent, in descent mode, the aircraft will target basically that ball, our vertical profile. If we had a late descent instruction from ATC and we overfly our top of descent, we'll get a decelerate message here and on our primary flight display. In that case, you will want to bring the speed right back to green dots until you get your clearance, and then use open descent by pulling down and dialing in a high speed. If you had speed restrictions, obviously we'll have to maintain those, and you may need to use the speed brake to recapture the profile. So because we're descending, we want to put our constraints on, so we see what's happening on our approach. And we can use the progress page here to look at our vertical deviation here. So we're pretty much on it, 30 feet below actually, so nothing to worry about there. If we were cleared now to flight level 200 to descend per the star, the standard terminal arrival route that we're on, select that, you'll see that we get 260 magenta here because it's going to adhere to the restrictions that are in place. So we've got 200 cleared in the FCU, but the aircraft will not descend below that until we're past in-pip, at which point it will descend to reach flight level 200 at in-rev. If we were cleared straight away to descend and you wanted to ignore those restrictions, we can enter open descent mode, and the aircraft in this mode targets the speed. If we wanted to increase our rate of descent, we could dial in a higher speed, for example. But we don't want to do that today because we have hard restrictions we want to meet on our standard terminal arrival route. So as pilots, we monitor our vertical deviation all the way down, making sure we're meeting restrictions on the approach. You'll see we've got this magenta box here, these brackets opened up here on the speed tape, and this is allowing the aircraft flex in terms of speed to keep us on profile. So the aircraft could increase speed up to the top of that, up to the top bracket, or reduce speed to the bottom bracket, with the triangle there in the middle being our target speed. So we're passing over in-pip now, we've got speed, flight level 200 blue, and the aircraft now needs to descend to make flight level 200 at in-rev. So our vertical descent is increasing, and speed is increasing as well to achieve that target. In the descent, we want to look out for icing conditions. If our TAT temperature is plus 10 or below, we want to get the engine anti-ice on, and we've got some visible moisture. Obviously the clouds coming in, it's going to get a little hazy out there, so I'm going to turn the engine anti-ice on now. We usually do that in advance of entering icing conditions, and we want to look out for visible ice, so looking at our icing probe up here around the windshield. Also we may get an icing alert, in which case any of those happen, we'll use wing anti-ice. The next thing we want to consider is the use of seat belts. It's a good idea at the top of descent to give the cabin an announcement, just saying cabin crew, top of descent, and they'll know that they'll be landing in approximately half an hour's time. Ideally, you want the seat belts on 15 minutes before landing. In any case, if there's turbulence, get the seat belts on. And looking ahead at the weather, we may get them on a little bit early today. So in speed, rate of descent's increasing now. And an extra restriction is tartan, so we could say 70 at tartan, so we could dial that in now. We've got 200 magenta, 70 in the FCU, which is quite a tight restriction to get down in that number of track miles, so we'll see how the system copes with that. Checking deviations. We're on profile now, so we're crossing in rev at flight level 200 as per the restriction. Crossing in rev, 70 is blue. We're speeding up now, so it's a tight restriction. We've got a 250 knot restriction here coming up, so that's an issue. If you're struggling with making restrictions, don't hesitate to ask ATC if the restriction can be removed. See, the ball is escaping us now, so we have more drag messages starting to come up, just flashed up there. The aircraft is going above its target speed here, it's trying to do its best to keep us on profile. But this 250 knot restriction, which we'll have to meet shortly, is an issue. Some more drag required, so at this point we want to throw in our speed brakes. Help it out. This allows the nose of the aircraft to pitch down, get a higher descent rate without increasing the speed. And the ball is now slowly coming back up, and our deviation is decreasing. Oh, it's increasing again. It's still struggling. If you are struggling to make a restriction, you do want to contact air traffic control as far in advance as possible so they can factor that in. You see, we have got this little magenta point here, that is a deceleration point. So the aircraft needs to start bringing back speed here again to maintain 230 knots. And then we've got another restriction here as well, 210 knots. Feet above profile. Profile's coming back in, and this line here indicates when we'll be back on the profile, this blue marker here. So just before tartan. So we're okay for now in our current configuration with speed brakes deployed. We're going to get the seatbelts on now. Looks like some clouds ahead. Look a bit ugly, those clouds. And so the descent is all about monitoring your profile, looking ahead of the aircraft, seeing if you need to help it out. So flight level 100, we want to get our landing systems on each side. Wanted a bit of a scan, making sure our seat belts are on. And we want to get the landing lights on at this point. Make sure everything is looking sensible. So the profile's coming back in now. We want to set up our EFIS for our arrival, so we've got constraints. We could range this down a little bit. Best officer would do the same on their side. So we're back in profile. Bring the speed brakes back in now. We want to use speed brakes as little as possible because it is inefficient. Crossing the deceleration point. I'm now going to activate our approach phase in the performance page of our MCDU. Confirm. That brings our speed back to green dots, which is now pretty much on our next speed. So about 211 knots green dot speed. 210 is our restriction. So it's a sensible time to activate the approach phase. Our platform altitude for the final approach is 4,000 feet. And we can descend now to 6,000. The cabin ready. Hello.
The cabin is now secure for landing.
Thank you. See you on the ground. So we need to be plus 6,000 at our next waypoint, 210 knots. Just below green dots, so we'll go flaps 1, speed checks, flaps 1. And approaching our transition, we don't need to select the new QNH until we're below transition. That's just serving as a reminder. Alt starts are requiring flight level 60. At restriction of 210 knots. Looking nice in profile and turning overhead this waypoint, where our next restriction is plus 5,000 feet. 5,000 in, and that's going now on to local pressure 1009. Let's cross check 3 times, passing 58 now. Checked. Start. Halt. Always confirm your FMAs. Approach checklist, bar ref QNH is set 1009. Three times cross checked, seatbelts are on, and we confirm that on the ECAM. Minimums, we've got 310 in, confirmed. Auto brake is low as needed. Approach checklist complete. So we can come down to 4000 feet now, dial that in. Bring the range down on our APHIS for situational awareness. It's possible to get vectors here, and we may be turned in at a slightly better angle to intercept the ILS. And we can do manage speed now and come back on the speed. So we've been cleared by air traffic control for the approach, so we select approach over here, autopilot 1 and 2. I want to confirm our ILS frequency, India Victor Golf 1089. That's correct, and we are lock start, alt start, turning inbound. Temperatures for icings are plus 8, so we're still in icing risk. Cap free door, autopilot 1 and 2. And the glide slopes coming in. So that's the descent and approach. I hope you found that useful. If you have any questions on that, please drop them in the comments. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. Thanks for watching.